Student, today we study the science third chapter, fiber to fabric. This is a part one video. So in last class we studied second chapter, nutrition in animal. So we are in this chapter, it's called fiber to fabric. This is a general topic. This is a simple chapter you should easily learn. So fibers. Fabric, have you wool obtained from hair of sheep got yarn? Have you seen wool, woolen thread, silks? Some you have used. Yeah, when winter season arrives, we wear sweater, right? We wear sweater. Why we wear sweater? Because coldness. So to avoid coldness, we use wool. The sweater we used. The sweater is made up of a wool. Where the sweater is made up of a wool. Where we get this wool? The wool is obtained from the hair. Hair of fleek. So called fleek. The hair of sheep, goat, yeah, some animals which have a hair in their skins. Have you seen sheep? Any sheep, goat or yak? Yeah. So they have a hair or fleek. So the wools are obtained from the sheep or goat and yak. Okay. So what is the animal fiber? Animal fiber is silk and wool. What is the animal fiber is that? Silk and wool. So in this class, we study how wools are produced. How we can prepare wool from the animal skin. Okay. So in introduction, the animals like, yeah, you have a very seen sheep, goat and yak, okay. These are the main three animals. Say they have a thick hair, or thick hair means the thick fleek. We call it as hair is in that animal called fleek. Though they have a thick fleek which they trap the air. So the animals like sheep, goat, yak, they are covered with a thick hair. So what happened? These hair helped to trap air. So when this is animal, imagine this is animal. This is hair. These hair are very thick. When air is entered, they trap the air. That means they could not enter to air inside the skin. So they cover the skin of animals. So what happened? Air is a poor conductor of heat. So air is a poor conductor. It does not capacity of heat. So what that means? The air is very cold. So what happened that time? When this air, cold air entered our skin, we start to shiver. Right? We feel very cold. Wow, I can't. So we cut. Mom give sweaters. We call your mom. Right? So that time, that these animals, they cover their hairs because they are very thick. So this cold air could not enter their skin. Then their body will get very hot. The body temperature is maintained. Okay. What happened? So these hairs, these are fibers which are obtained from the animals. There are two types of fibers are there. How many types of fibers is there? There are two types of fibers of fleek. Fleek means hair. So there are two types of fleek is there. First one is a coarse braid hair, braid hair. So braid hair is outermost hair which are very thick. It's a broad hair. Second one is a fine soft hair. Second one is fine soft hair. So which hair is we have useful? We have a useful is a fine soft hair. The fine soft hair is very useful to us. Why? Because they are inside the body, inside the skin. Inside skin, not in the skin, there is a container hair. So upper layer has a broad hair, bright hair, and soft hair is under the bright hair. So they are very These are very helpful to the that time. So we have these use sheets are very useful. So some sheets or some bark, they produce only fine hair only. So such sheets are very useful to us. So what happened? The people start to breed their families. Only fine hair sheets can they can breed because they produce a very fine hair which are useful to us to make a wool or fine. Okay, understood. Some places the wools are very useful in like in places like Tibet, Ladakh, Kashmir, so North Indian places, because they are very cold regions. They are very cold. We can't maintain our body temperature. So that place always using wools. So they use wools and using sweaters, gloves. So some Angora. This is Angora. There is an Angora type. Is a wools are there which are produced by Angora gods, which are produced by Angora gods. Some other is Kashmiri type of wools also there, which also produced by Kashmiri god. K god means Kashmiri god, which are very soft. This Kashmiri woolen is very soft, and we have to use in everywhere. So this is a very demand for a Kashmiri. So there are various type places have a various type woolen will be there, because they breed their type of sheep or goats. So we have start forming fiber to wool. So in this class we start how fiber we can prepare from the wool. So there are so many procedure will be there. Like we study one step by step. Okay, what happened? The wool is produced by the sheep, goat or yak. So these have we have feed sheep. We have a grass, corn, oil, eggs. That means oil materials of some crops. Okay, so we have feed. Have you seen any TV channels or when you go to North Indians, the road full covered by the sheep. They eat some grasses. They eat some corn. Have you seen? Yeah, you must. You have seen some pictures, some channels, right? So they feed sheep and to as a grass, corn, some oil material food. Okay, so the breeds of sheep given a quality of fiber. So which breed? When we breed a sheep, that breed of sheep is producing the quality of the fiber. If you breed the best quality of sheep, then sheep provide a best quality of fiber. If we breed a poor quality of sheep, they give only poor quality of fiber. So breeding is depends upon the quality of the fiber. Okay, what is the process? How forming the fiber to wool? What is the process? So they have a four total five steps. One, two, five steps. What is this? First, the fleece of sheep. Fleece of sheep means the fleece of sheep thin skin remove then to a shaving using a barber machine. Have you understood? No children. So I will explain. What the fleece of sheep means? The hair contained in sheep. The hair of sheep is the and thin skin. The sheep thin skin and the hair is removed through a shaving. Shaving means the procedure. We remove the skin and the hair through a barber machine. Have you seen the barber machine? When your father is removed beard, right? So the barber through a barber machine, they remove the flake of skin off and flake and thin skin of a sheep. So what happened? This is the first step. When they remove the skin and hair in a hot weather, only hot weather, because when we take out in a winter season or a cold weather, they start to shivering, right? Their skin is removed. They can't trap their air, cold air. So they start to shiver. So always skins and hair is removed in time of hot weather. This is first. So first step, the screen with hair, the shivered skin with hair is washed. Next step, what is second step? They remove skin, right? Skin and hair, they can be washed. Why? Because they wash it because removing dust. To remove dust, some greases, some oil contents which are covered in their hair, outermost hair, so they can start to wash. In your textbook, they given you pictures of each process. So open your textbook, watch these pictures carefully. Okay? What happened? The skin wash with hair, skin with hair, wash it, remove it to remove dust. So this process is called scouring. What we call this process as? This process we called as a scouring. Okay, have you understood? Right. What happened? After scouring, there is a sorting is take place. What does it mean? Sorting. Third step is sorting. What is the meaning of sorting? The hair sent to a factory. The washed hair or thin skins which are washed, then they are sent to a factory. Such process is called as a sorting. Okay. Next, the small in factory, third step, in factory, there is a small fluffy fiber is called as a burrs. There is a when the factory reaches that skins and hairs, they color pick out the small hairs or small flick. This small flick, flicker picked out. So this is called as a burrs. And then again they can scour. Again they can scour. Scour means again they wash the skins. But then they are dry. Then they will do a dry. So now the skin is washed, cutted, then removed, then is a washer. The process is covering. Then it's sorting, sent to a factory. Next up, they have collected burrs as small. The small skin has then again scoured and dried. In fifth step, dyed in colors means after the dry they give a particular color. Why? Because sheep got always black or white in color, right? So their skin is always black and white. So the human beings didn't like when they use a black and white. They needed it's a very bright colors. So some they have like red, some are yellow, some are green, some are pink, etc. So the people do a dyed in color. They give a colors to that hairs. Then what happened last step, the lace fibers are straightened. So which they are in mixed in procedure, they start to straighten. They have a straighten, this is like a thread. And they have a comb and roll it to yarn. What happened? They have a comb and they start to roll. They were rolled in a particular procedure for yarn. Then they use as a sweaters, as small in spawns and woolen clothes. So these are the main steps. First step is the remove the fleek of sheep through a shivering. That is processed, shivering processed using barber's machine in hot weather. Second procedure is scouring, means skin with hair is washed in water to remove dust particle. Then third step is in the sorting, means the hair sent to a factory. Then fourth one is in the small fluffy skins or hairs are removed, picked out. This is called as a burrs. Then again remaining woolen threads, the woolen hairs are used as a scoured and dried. Then they have using dyed in color, they have used a dye. Then last, the fibers are in striping, they have combed and rolled, then used in as a sweaters and as in woolen clothes. So you have understood, right? So next to study some interesting topic of